Let me give you a very quick refresher on encryption. There are two families of encryption systems. One is the private key cryptosystem. And in the private key cryptosystem, both the sender and the receiver use symmetric keys for encryption of the data and decryption of the data. A common private key system that we all are using probably on an everyday basis is passwords. When we log into either a corporate network or a university network, we use a username and password, and that is using a private key encryption system. The idea is simple. The sender takes the data that they want to send to a receiver, encrypts the data using a key, and this key is a private key that is known only to the sender and the receiver and nobody else. So by encrypting the data with this key, they produce what is called a ciphertext. And the ciphertext can go on insecure links. Anybody can see the bit pattern of the ciphertext. But in order to make sense out of the ciphertext, they have to decrypt it. And to decrypt it, they need the key. And the key is only available between the sender and the receiver. So this is where Salzer's principle comes into play, that is, publish the design, but protect the key. The keys are protected between the sender and the receiver. You're publishing the method by which you are transferring information between sender and receiver, namely using a private key encryption system. But for any bad guy to access information that is flowing on the wire, they have to have the key in order to make sense out of the data that is flowing. And you make breaking the key hard enough computationally that the system is secure. Now, one of the problems with the private key system is the fact that the keys have to be distributed to the sender and the receiver, and key distribution problem is one of the difficulties with private key cryptosystems, especially as the size of the organization becomes larger and larger. The public key cryptosystem overcomes this key distribution problem. And in this case, there is a public key that is published. The name itself suggests the idea behind the public key cryptosystem, and that is anyone can create an encrypted data by taking this public key, which is available, let's say, published in the yellow pages. They can take that public key, take the data that they want to send, encrypt it, and send it on the wire. But in order to decrypt that data, the public key is no good. You need a private key that is the only way to decrypt this data. But in other words, the mathematical underpinning of the public key cryptosystem is that there are asymmetric keys, a pair of keys for information exchange. In order to encrypt, you use a key that is a public key. Anybody can have access to that. But in order to decrypt that, you need a private key. And conversion of data into a ciphertext using the public key is a one-way function, which is not reversible. Similarly, converting the encrypted message into the original data using the private key is another one-way function. So one-way functions are the mathematical basis for the public key cryptosystem. So now, the way you would send data, if you're the sender, take the data, encrypt it using the public key. You create a ciphertext. Once you have the ciphertext, you cannot convert it back to the data using the public key. The only entity that can convert the ciphertext back to its original data is the entity that has the private key, the other part of this asymmetric key infrastructure, namely the private key. And using the private key, you can decrypt the ciphertext and create the original data. So this is the workflow for a sender to encrypt the data, create a ciphertext, send it to the receiver. Receiver decrypts it using the private key and produces the original data.